A very good evening and warm welcome to Dhamma Television's Collective News. This is Srishti Khatki. Let's move on to today's headline. Construction of statues of Sankadar Shakwa and Padmaratna Tuladhar. Corona infection estimated to affect 2% population. Inauguration of Khumbu Miteri Bridge. Corona confirmed to another 1,674 on Saturday. 16.6 million active corona infections worldwide. 254 corona infected people died in Germany in last 24 hours. COVID-19 infection in more than 4 lakh people in Bangladesh. Kabul rocket attack kills 8, injures dozens. Prohibition in the United States. Protest saying China interfered in Nepal's internal affairs. Here we go for news in detail. A statue of national icon Sankadar Shakwa and human rights activist Padmaratna Tuladhar, who made significant contribution to the movement for language and ethnic equality, has been erected at Sankadar Udyan in Kathmandu. Minister for Urban Development Krishna Gopal Shrestha unveiled the statue at Sankadar Udyan near Rani Pokhari on Saturday. After unveiling, Minister Shrestha and others laid wreaths at the statue. Speaking on the occasion, Minister Shrestha said that construction of a statue in former Ratna Park, that is the current Sankadar Udyan, was a positive thing. Minister Shrestha assured that Kathmandu city would be organized now. Minister Shrestha said that work of filling potholes in the roads of Kathmandu has been started and it will be monitored continuously. Similarly, Vidyasundar Shakya, chief of Kathmandu Metropolitan City, argued that process of constructing statues has started from the state level. Mayor Shakya said that Metropolis has done people-centered work even during corona epidemic. Mayor Shakya claimed that image of Kathmandu Metropolis was gradually changing. The statue was built by Mahesh Tuladhar with an investment of around ₹2 million. Chairman of National Assembly Ganesh Prasad Timmalsina has said that role of people's representatives is important to reduce corona infection. Speaking at a discussion program organized by Ministry of Health in Kathmandu on Saturday on role of parliamentarians for effective communication in COVID-19 epidemic and risks, Timmalsina said that people's representatives should play a role in preventing spread of infection by making their voters aware. Timmalsina also mentioned that everyone should take precaution to stop corona infection in case they are not sure when the vaccine will come for the treatment of corona. Timmalsina suggested that political parties should mobilize fraternal organization for corona control and conduct awareness programs in the villages to lay a strong foundation for political future. Similarly, Health Minister Bhanu Bhaktadakal said that government was committed to provide door-to-door health services. Minister Dakal also said that government was working to manage beds with oxygen required for the treatment of corona and facilitate supply of medicines. Minister Dakal also claimed that government has made every effort to prevent corona infection. Mapya Khumbu Miteri Bridge connecting Mapya Dudkosi Municipality and Khumbu Pasanglamu Municipality of Solukhumbu has been inaugurated. Chief Minister of Province 1, Sardan Rai, inaugurated Miteri Bridge on Saturday. Inauguration of a bridge at Olanghat in Dudkosi to establish road access to the world's highest peak Everest was delayed due to corona epidemic. Inaugurating the bridge, Chief Minister of Province 1, Rai, said that Dora development has opened in the area after reconstruction of two villages. Chief Minister of Province 1, Rai, said that construction of the bridge has opened the door for the tourists to reach the base area of Everest. Chief Minister of Province opined that country has moved ahead on the path of development and bridges have been built due to the transformation of the country into a federal system. Stating that people have not seen the pattern of development in the past, Rai said that development is possible now that all the power and authority is in the hands of people. 48-meter long and 6-meter wide bridge has been completed by Jal of Nepal through tender at a cost of ₹72.97 million. Federal Parliamentary Fund has invested ₹10 million, province government has invested ₹20 million, and the remaining Dudkosi and Khumbu Pasanglamu municipalities have invested in construction of the bridge. Capacity of the bridge is 55 tons. Corona has been confirmed in 1,674 more people in Nepal on Saturday. At the same time, number of corona infections in Nepal has reached 2,18,639. According to Ministry of Health, 7 more people have died due to corona infection, while 1,305 people have already died from corona infection in Nepal. Similarly, 2,323 infected people have been cured in Nepal, and 1,93,325 have been released from corona. At present, there are 24,009 people in isolation and 757 people in quarantine in Nepal. So far, 16,53,043 PCRs have been performed in Nepal. Similarly, corona was confirmed in 899 people in Kathmandu Valley on Saturday. Of them, 685 in Kathmandu, 49 in Bhaktapur, and 165 in Lalitpur are infected. More than a year after the outbreak of coronavirus, number of active infections worldwide has reached 16.6 million. In the last 24 hours, 576,000 of people have been infected. At the same time, number of active infected people around the world has reached 16,630,378. Of these, 12,391 are in critical condition. According to Worldometers, total number of infected people has reached 58.47 million. Out of that, more than 4,459,000 have become infection-free. Similarly, 10,890 people have died in last 24 hours. At the same time, number of deaths due to corona worldwide has reached 1.38 million. In Europe alone, 3,898 people have died in last 24 hours since the outbreak of second wave. Corona is leading cause of death in Europe, with more than 54,000 deaths in Britain. In the UK alone, 341 infected people have died in last 24 hours. That toll has risen to 54,626. Death toll has risen across the UK and Europe as number of people infected with winter has risen. In Europe, Italy has the second highest number of deaths after the United Kingdom. So far, 49,261 people have died in Italy. Similarly, more than 48,000 people have died in France. France is the third most infected country in Europe. With the second wave of transition, most European countries have issued new transactions rules. Following the outbreak of infection, restrictions have been lifted in European countries. Countries including Britain, Italy, and France have issued curfews. However, infection has not decreased. Total number of people infected with coronavirus in Germany has reached more than 9 million. According to government officials on Saturday, a total of 90,528 people have been infected in Germany. Number of people infected with coronavirus in a single day has reached 23,000. Officials said, according to officials, a total of 22,964 people have been infected in Germany in the last 24 hours. 254 people have died in a single day due to coronavirus infection. Death toll has risen to 13,884. So far, officials said, number of those who have been infected and are now free of infection is more than 590,000. Number of those infected a day ago has reached 23,648, and number of deaths has reached 260. World Health Organization has declared a global outbreak of coronavirus since March. Since March 11, corona has so far infected 579,015,559 people worldwide and killed 13,077,826 people. Number of COVID-19 infected people in Bangladesh has reached 445,281 as of Saturday, according to National Directorate of Health Services. In Muslim-majority country, more than 6,350 people have died from COVID-19. In last 24 hours, 12,643 people have been tested for COVID-19 on suspicion and 1,847 people have been infected. Another 28 people have died of COVID-19 infection on Saturday. In Bangladesh, 3,60,352 people have recovered so far, including 1,921 who were infected on Saturday. According to government figures, death rate from COVID-19 infection in Bangladesh is 1.43%, while 80.93% of the patients have recovered and returned home. The highest number of 4,019 people infected on the same day was on July 2nd, while the highest number of deaths on the same day was on June 30. Rocket attack in Afghan capital has risen to 8. Terrorist groups have fired about 23 rounds of rockets into Afghan capital Kabul, says government officials. According to preliminary information, 8 people were killed and 31 others were injured in attack. Afghan Interior Minister has accused Taliban of involvement in attack. Home Ministry spokesperson Tariq Aryan said government had received information that Taliban had carried out attack, adding that government would provide medical treatment to all injured. Prohibitions have resumed in the United States, where new records are being set daily. Most states have made the use of masks mandatory. States like New York, Texas, and California have issued restraining orders after infection increase. California has issued a nighttime curfew since Saturday. There's a ban on walking from 10 p.m. to 5 a.m. to control infection. Ban will last until at least December 21. BBC quoted officials. They are saying that situation could be extended. Ban will apply even at Christmas if infection increases. California restaurants are only allowed to do home delivery. Of the 58 countries in the state, 41 are most affected. There is a stay-at-home order issued. Some countries are expected to issue strict curfews. Earlier, a night ban was also imposed in New York. Center for Disease Control and Prevention urges all Americans not to travel long distances on Thanksgiving Day, November 26. So far, more than 12.46 million people have been infected in the United States. Of them, 261,790 have died. In California alone, more than 1.1 million people have been infected. Protests have taken place in mighty gear saying that China has interfered in Nepal's internal affairs and China has encroached on Nepal's land. A group of independent youth staged a demonstration in Kathmandu on Saturday, demanding an end to Chinese interference. Youths who participated in demonstration displayed placards saying, "Go back China." Nepali land cannot be eroded and Chinese expansionism. Demonstration said that China should show its attitude in northern part of Nepal and return Nepalese land. This is all for now. We'll be back with more news and updates. Till then, keep watching Dharma Television. May all the sentient beings be at peace. Stay safe.